take the risk or lose the chance. I'm Anthony, and I'm gonna take you through today's PF Go workout. We got a super fun one for you today. We have a warm up with 2 rounds of 10 passive active hangs, 10 kip swings, and ring rows, or some strict pull-ups, that's your choice. Now, if you're in the gym, we'll walk you through all the procedures and the body shapes. If you're not, we got some stuff for you here. What we're gonna do is grab onto a dumbbell or a pair of dumbbells. Instead of passive active hangs, we're gonna do some shrugs. Keeping those shoulder blades back together, lifting up nice and high, and lowering back down. Pop it up, hold, and lower. We're gonna have these nice and controlled. As you lift up, we want you to lift back at the same time. Now we'll put those down and we're gonna do everyone's favorite core workout. We're gonna do arch hold, hollow hold, rolling in between. We're gonna lay down on our stomach, arms stretched out in an arch position. Your eyes and chest are up. Now from here, the only thing that's in contact is your belly. We're gonna roll over like a turtle, and now the only thing that's in contact is your low back and your butt. Then we'll just roll back into center. That's the fun one, good. I'm not gonna make Erica do any more of those because I don't want you to know how fun they are until you guys get here and jump on them. So over and back is one, we'll do 10 reps. So I would do 5 right and then 5 to the left to start out. Now we'll finish the ring rows or strict pull-ups with bent over rows if you don't wanna do those. We're gonna drop that chest down, pull in, down. In and down. Nice and consistent. We're just warming up those biceps, warming up those lats for today. Now we'll take a quick break, shake those arms out. We have one more round of hangs, kip swings, and ring rows or pull-ups, or shrugs, hollow body arch rolls, or bent over rows. Now our second round of warm-up is alternating Spider-Mans, scap push-ups, and a 200 meter run. Let's start with the Spider-Mans. We're gonna go in a nice deep lunge from a plank. Reach one hand down and reach up. So Erica's left foot is forward. That means her left hand is doing the work here, up and down. We're gonna do one on one side, switch one on the other. The goal here is just to do 5 on each side, alternating, not 10 on each side. That would take you too long. Now we'll go to that plank position again and we'll warm up our scap push-ups. In that push-up position, the shoulder blades come together and they spread apart. We're moving those shoulder blades just like this. As you can see, she's not getting any bend in the elbows or any change in shape in the body. All the movement comes from the shoulder blades. Now we have 200 meter run. This might be some people's first time running, and if you are interested in running, today is a good workout to start planning ahead for. So a nice short 200 meter jog, out the garage door, down the ramp, touch the sign, come on back in. We'll take the first one nice and easy. Second one, we'll pick it up. Remember the rules of the road though. Stay to the right and you won't run into anybody. Now, we're all done with the warm-up, and I have some good news for today. Memorial Day MRF is coming up, and we're gonna start preparing you for that workout. Now, if you've never done MRF, it's a 1 mile run at the beginning and a 1 mile run at the end. In the middle, you have 100 pull-ups, 200 push-ups, 300 squats. The good news is you don't have to go mile, 100, 200, 300 mile. You can break them up any way you want. You could do 100 rounds of 1, 2, 3. You could do 20 rounds of 5, 10, 15. There are a lot of different ways to go about this. You can grab a partner, do the runs together, split up the work, and then do the run together to finish it out. We just love doing this event, and it's a great community builder for us. So what we're gonna do today is a broken down version of MRF. On a 12 minute clock, you're gonna start with a 1 mile run into max rounds of Cindy. Then we're gonna do a 2 minute rest. Then we have a 6 minute clock, 800 meter run Cindy, then a 2 minute rest. Then a 4 minute running clock into 400 meter run, and then max rounds of Cindy. So let's go through what is Cindy. 5 pull-ups, 10 push-ups, 15 squats. So we'll start with the squats. You guys know what these look like. Hands up nice and high. These are fast squats. Down and up, cycling through nice and quick. What I need to make sure of is 2 things. 1, when you stand all the way up, your hips come all the way forward. 2, at the bottom, we wanna make sure your hips are below your knees. Now, there's a good way and a bad way to do this. Can you drop your chest and be a little bit lazy for me? What tends to happen, and do a couple reps, is that people get tired, their arms are tired, and while their lower body might be doing something that resembles a squat, the upper body can just get a little bit lazy. So make sure that at the very end, you're not sticking your butt out, you're just back to fully upright. If you can squeeze your glutes, you're done the squat. I'd rather you go a little slower and do them right. Now, push-ups. This is the hardest part of this workout, hands down. Chest hits the floor. Tap and press. You don't have to come to rest, you don't have to pick your hands up, but this is the kind of workout where we'd wanna break it up early. Now, Cindy is 5 pull-ups or ring rows, 10 push-ups, 15 squats. That's one round. So we're gonna cycle through that as many times as we can. Now this 12-minute running clock, we have a 1 mile run. That might take some people 6 minutes, it might take some people 10 minutes. Either way, when you come back in, you start with 5 pull-ups, 10 push-ups, 15 squats, cycle, 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 until that 12 minutes hits. Then you get 2 minutes rest, everyone will rest together, shake your arms out, shake your legs out. Then we're gonna go over to the garage doors, we're gonna start a 6 minute timer. This one's gonna be an 800 meter run, so half the distance. You wanna try and stay about half the time. I don't expect you to go a little bit faster. Then you come on in, you go 5, 10, 15, over, 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 over again. Then we got our 2 minute rest at the end of the 6 minutes, and our final piece of workout is a 4 minute clock, a 400 meter run, which should be between 1 and 2 minutes, and that leaves you 2 minutes to finish it on out. You should be sweaty, you should be tired, you should be a little bit hot, but this is a great way to start preparing for that 100, 200, 300 with that 2 mile run in the workout. I'd love to hear what you think of our first Murph Prep workout. Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to let us know what you think of the programming. We can't wait to walk you through this one. Have a great workout. Have a great rest of your day.